So hey guys, welcome back. I'm Rachel over at That 1870s Homestead. And first off, I just want to apologize for not catching how I started this process, but it was too good not to share what I think is going to be the results. Today I'm making my first ever fermented hot sauce. And I got this recipe sort of from the World Wide Web, but there was nothing that really called out exactly what peppers I had. So we're gonna go through the process of turning this into hot sauce. Okay, so in my ferment, I have chilies, garlic, onions, jalapenos, and maybe like two cayenne peppers. Those are the only types of peppers that I grew this year. And then it's just in a salt water brine. I am using the glass pebbles from Mason Top. I'll show you when I open it, and the Mason Top lid. And it's been sitting in here now for just over 4 weeks. The active fermentation process has dramatically slowed down. About a week and a half ago, it was just vigorously bubbling. So that was good to see. Everything has stayed below the liquid using the pebble. So I'm not fearful that there was any mold introduced, but we're going to check again once I open it up. So I'm going to bring you guys along with me as we open this, strain it off, process it, and then I'm going to see if I can get Todd to do a taste test for us. Okay? Okay, let's look and see what we've got. Oh, can't open it. There we go. Oh, maybe that is some mold there. So we're just gonna be careful. Looks like a little skim of film. So we won't pour it out that direction. Don't wanna introduce any mold into the blending process. Okay, so we have jalapenos. Okay, I just poured off that liquid that I strained out. Now we're gonna put all the yumminess into the blender. Ooh, spicy. And then we're gonna blend this all up. So I ended up adding the liquid back. I don't know why I even poured it out to begin with. It's gonna be loud while we process this, so we'll play you some fun music, but we're gonna process this. We're gonna run it through a fine mesh sieve and see how much we get. It's going in my throat. Whew! That is spicy, guys. I feel it. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna try this setup and see how this works. I always have this bad habit when I play with peppers that I forget to wash my hands when I'm done. And then I ultimately rub my eyes and pay the price for it. So I think what the recipe said is you could keep this pulp in your hot sauce if you wanted to, but we're not huge hot sauce eaters. So I think we'll just go with just the juice that we're getting out. It doesn't seem like it's gonna make a whole lot though. Maybe I should have done two or three batches. Okay, that's what we've got. Minus the bits that I spilled. It's definitely not thick. It's more like hot sauce juice. Interesting. What do you think? Should I put that pulp back in the blender and see if I can get it any finer and then add it to this? No? Okay. Well, that's what they said. But you couldn't even eat this on a cracker if you wanted to. It's like juice. It looks like hot sauce. Okay, well, we're gonna try it. So to kill the heat already, just because we are a little bit sissy, we did put some cheese on it.
I want to try some without cheese first.
Oh, though. You do?
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna let you pour it because it's really juicy.
I'm not a hot person.
But you do like a little spice.
Oh, geez. See,
yeah. It's really juicy.
All right, well, I guess I get a lot. First thing you taste is garlic.
Oh, really?
And then you taste onion. And then it gets really hot.
Oh, no. I'm going to pour it over the cup. I think we should add the pulp back.
You can try.
I think I'm going to add the pulp back because it's just wasting a lot.
Not bad. I mean, my mouth is still burning, but.
Yeah. My tongue was immediately like going.
Mm-hmm. Our kids will like it. Our kids really like hot stuff.
Oh, so. They do. They like to do those spicy challenges. So it'll be good when everybody comes home at Christmas to dare them. Try mom's hot sauce. Okay. So I'm going to blend that pulp back up and see if I can't get this a little thicker. I won't bore you guys with that. The flavor's wonderful. It's really good.
It's hot.
Very fresh. But the freshness of it.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Did you taste the garlic at the beginning like I did?
No, just my tongue was on fire, so I couldn't taste anything. Anyway, that's our first attempt at making our own homemade hot sauce. And using the fermentation method. So I think that's the origination of how hot sauce would have been made. And since then, the commercial industry's kind of gotten away from that. So try it. If you have extra peppers left over from the fall, see if you guys can't make your own version of hot sauce. I'm gonna keep my Frank's bottle so I could pour it in there.
Good job.
Thanks. Back to blending.
All right, well, thanks for joining us.
Yep. See you guys next time.